since 2015, 2014, Save the Children globally did various assessments, and they found out that people who live in cities, the majority of them actually, don't have access to services because of their poverty, because of their location in slums. So access is limited. Out of this came the idea of why can't we intervene and support the delivery of services in informal settlements in Nairobi. So we selected Kibra because Kibra was the biggest, largest informal settlement. So we created a partnership with a company called THINKMD that own a software called MedSync. Now this software is easy to use by any healthcare worker, especially those in the front line. Any healthcare worker can use this application.
It was through the Save the Children that we came to learn about the app and also got trained. And since then, we've been using it to attend to clients. You know, initially we would like attend to these kids below 5 years, like you just attend to a child generally. But see, with the application, it's more of, it narrows down. At the end of it all, you find that you come up with a diagnosis that is more accurate and also treatment that is up to date and also up to standard.
Actually, they have created a relationship and trust from the parent, because they go saying that, actually I never knew my child had this disease, but the machine that Dr. Rihanna is using has helped me to know that my child is suffering from a disease which I never knew.
Kifaa hicho ni nakipenda maana nimeona kinafaa kinakaa kuwa accurate na kinapima mtoto kwa muda mfupi sana. Na unaambiwa mtoto wako ako na shida gani.
Teknolojia inanipa confidence ya kuja kwa ajili, inafanya vitu kuwa nyepesi vile vile. Unajua na ni real shida ya mtoto inatokea hapo, unaona na unajua kweli ni ukweli.
So you find during when we're using the app, we were able to have people following the guidelines as per the way they were put, and they were able to ask all those questions, look for all the statistics they need to find or the vital stats, and they're also able to send for the appropriate management and get a proposed tailored treatment.
We trained about 87 healthcare workers from 67 health facilities, and these healthcare workers assessed the child and treated the child based on the guidelines of the Ministry of Health.
Most clinicians find it much easier to use because they are able to actually just go through it so fast and able to see their patients without wasting a lot of time thinking, so should I ask about this? Should I? Because it's already there guiding you what to do. So you find most clinicians have a very positive attitude towards it in regards to its usage.
Our plan is to train totally around 190 qualified healthcare workers, nurses and clinical officers, on the use of this application. We feel it's possible, it's sustainable. Why? First of all, everything is done by the Ministry of Health now. Save the Children is just supporting the ministry to conduct these activities.
Currently, where we are moving, we actually need to embrace, engage, and also go through the innovation way. So the digital health, artificial intelligence, all these need to actually be put in a place where health can access.
Finally, if this software that we're using, this application, is accepted by the Ministry of Health at sub-county level, hopefully this will be scaled up to other sub-counties also, other sub-counties in the country.